Charlotte, are you ready, sweetie?
You look beautiful, sweetheart.
Thank you, Mom.
I have something for you. This is a special box. I have been carrying it around in my pocket for the past 8 years. We picked it up the day after you were born. It's something your father wanted you to have. You want to see what's inside? I was going to give it to you on your 18th, but I thought that 8 was close enough. And besides, you need a ring to go with that fancy dress. Go ahead, try it on. See how it fits. Well, I know it's a little big, but you'll grow into it.
Thanks, Mom.
I love you, sweetie. Happy birthday. Hey, well, it is time to go because the show's gonna start soon.
As graceful as I used to be.
That was brilliant.
Wait till you see the chap tonight.
Who's play?
Fella by the name of Labachi. I think that's how you say it. Young musician, very skilled. Makes me look like a monkey. But that's the beauty of theatre, Graham. People more gifted, more talented. Come to this place. And let us be part of the greatness, even for an evening. One day it'll all be yours.
What? The Acorn?
Come on. Showtime.
Enjoy the show.
It's not profitable enough. This whole fiasco you got going here. It's a lost opportunity, wasted real estate. People don't want classical anymore. They want modern cinema.
Everyone's here for classical, Mr. Ives.
What's not profitable?
Lights, musicians, tuning your fancy piano. And how much are you paying those squares tonight anyway?
Enjoy the show.
Movie theaters are dark. They're low maintenance, very profitable. I hire one dope as a projectionist, one as a receptionist, and one as a concessionist, and before you know it, I've got a franchise.
People love classical, Mr. Ives.
That's because they don't know any better. Take this idiot, for example. Dumb enough to spend $4 for a lame piano recital. Surely he'll spend $1.50 to see Rock Hudson on the giant screen, huh?
Enjoy the show.
Yeah, I'm telling you. People around here don't know what they're missing. They need someone to show them the future. Someone who will get rid of all of this classical crap and introduce them to a new world of excitement. You think when Shakespeare first came around, people liked him? Maybe they did, maybe they didn't, who knows? The point is, he introduced something new. He was an innovator, like me. I have been innovating since I was in high school.
Hey!
Guy with the hole punch, yeah, you buddy. Can you punch a ticket for us? Love to see the show before it's over. Charlotte, save my seat. I'm gonna get us some drinks.
Enjoy the show.
Enjoy the show, buddy.
I like that guy. I tell you what, sign this joint over to me on Monday and I'll give you a handsome cut plus 5% of the net profits for the first fiscal year. Now, that is a fine deal if I ever heard one.
I'm not selling Mr. Ives. Ever.
Oh, you're a damn fool, boy. A damn fool.
Enjoy the show.
That's my fault. That's my fault. Here.
Just go to the John real quick. Clean up. I'll save your seat.
Girls, right?
Hey.
You're missing the show. Sit down. Sit.
Rod, I'm soaking wet.
Oh. Look, we didn't spend $8 on a ticket so you could hide out in the bathroom. Besides, you look great. It's dark in here.
Hello, Acorn Theatre, Rheaume speaking. Uh-huh. I see. I'll have a look around and give you a call if I find anything. What's your number? Okay. 90. And what was your name? Got it. I'll give you a call, Charlotte. Mm-hmm. Hi, is this Charlotte? Hi, it's Graham at the Acorn. Well, thank you. Listen, I searched around for your ring. I looked everywhere, but, well, no ring. Yes, I was sure to look there. Yes, I'm sure. I'll let you know if anything turns up. Right, to you as well. Bye.
Excuse me.
Oh. Hello.
Sorry to barge in like this. I tried to knock, but you probably couldn't hear me through the music.
Right. You must be the girl from the phone call?
Yes.
I'm terribly sorry about your ring. I looked everywhere, really.
If it'd be all right, if I could just look around for myself just for a little while.
Yeah, I'll just be, well, on ladders and such. Any luck?
No. No luck. May I?
By all means. I know this is probably the furthest thing from consolation, but it is, after all, just a ring. Things like that can be replaced, you know?
My mom gave me that ring. She bought it the day after I was born, and she gave it to me on my 8th birthday. And I've worn it every day since.
Oh.
It's kind of hard to replace things like that.
Well, you know, when I was a kid, I had a pocket watch. It didn't work. The gears inside were, well, it was just old. But I loved playing with it. Made me feel like a banker or something. I took it with me everywhere, all the time. But every night, I'd put it back on my nightstand next to my alarm clock, without fail. I was religious about it. Then one day, I went to get my pocket watch, and it wasn't there. I searched my room high and low, then the house, then the neighborhood. It was like it had disappeared. Months later, we were visiting my aunt's house in Acorn for Thanksgiving. I found it in my cousin's toy chest. I guess I say all that just to say, your ring will turn up. Just maybe not in the place you expected.
So you're saying my ring is in Ohio?
Well, it could be. Anything's possible. There's probably a 60% chance you'll find it in Percy's toy chest.
Those are not bad odds. How long have you worked here?
My whole life, really. My dad built the place well before I was born with a vision that people from all over the world would come and perform here. I used to just help with whatever he needed. Then, when he died, it sort of became mine.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. Show goes on.
Has anyone famous ever performed here?
Oh, sure, all the time.
Who was your favorite?
Liberace once played here when I was a kid. That was pretty cool.
I love Liberace. He plays some of my favorite music.
He's great, yeah.
And there are shows every weekend?
Yeah, for the most part.
Who's up next?
The children's choir, I believe, from Kalamazoo.
I don't know what all has to be done, but would you like some help setting up this week?
You're still hopeful you find your ring in here?
Maybe a little.
Good afternoon, miss. How can I help you?
I have a ring I'd like to sell, and I'd like to know if you can tell me what it's worth.
Well, let me take a look there.
Hello?
Charlotte, hey.
So the boys and I are coming. We're all gonna go get fries
and a malt down at Arnold's, see the wild one at 7, and then we're gonna catch the
submarine races after that. Sound good? I'll pick you up in 10.
I can't today, Rod. I have something going on.
Something going on? What do you got going on? It's Christmas break, for crying out loud.
Put the book down for 5 minutes and let me come pick you up.
Maybe this weekend, Rod. I'll talk to you later.
Charlotte! All right, which one of you has a sister I can take?
You answered the door this time.
I was looking out for strangers trying to break in.
So your father dies when you're 16, leaves you in charge of the theater, no staff. That's a lot of responsibility.
Yeah, it was. It was kind of scary at first, taking it all on. But it was fun. Get to meet a lot of amazing people.
Have you ever wanted to do anything different?
What do you mean?
I mean, have you ever wanted to do anything other than run the theater?
I suppose there are things I'd like to try, places I'd like to see. But I love the theater. It's home. Being here, I can still feel my dad. It's like he's shining down on me.
Payment's not due till Thursday!
Does this happen often?
Sometimes.
Do you have a candle?
My father was much better than me. I'm kind of a novice.
That was beautiful.
I'm sorry about your ring. I wish I could have found it for you.
It's all right. After all, things like that could be replaced, right?
Well, you know, you're more than welcome to have a look at my jewelry collection. Oh, I'm kind of a ring connoisseur. Yeah, any ring that fits your fancy, it's yours. I've got all sorts.
I don't think your rings would fit me.
Oh, we're pretty close in size, wouldn't you think? Come on. Right. Well, I guess my rings won't fit you. Sorry.
Thanks, Graham. I know a song on the piano if you want to hear it.
By all means.
Thank you.
going to find her ring. You're going to be her hero. And you're going to get the damn power turned back on around here.
Well, how about something like this?
Oh, hell no. Looks like it came out of a gumball machine. Look, it's our 30th. I want to give her something special. You know what I mean? What else you got?
Well, I do have this piece that just came in.
Oh, yeah. That is more like it. Sold. Put it on my tab. And say hi to your ball and chain for me, all right? Now, your pisser is down this way, right? Good.
Excuse me. Hi. I know this is kind of a random request, but I'm looking for a ring. It's a ring. It's reddish-orange. It has four little things that come to a point where the stone sits. A little diamond. Very petite thing. Fit a woman with very small hands. Have you got anything like that?
No, I'm afraid not. But could I interest you in a nice, fine necklace?
Nonsense. That property is worth half that at best. Well, tell him I'm not going over 50. Legal action. Yeah. Thanks for the good news. Look, I don't care what this idiot says. If it's not in the contract, it's not even real. I want his signature on that document by the end of the week, or there's no deal. You hear? And no more phone calls the rest of the day. It's Christmas time, for crying out loud. I should be able to hear a church mouse piss on a cotton ball in here. Yeah. Yeah, Merry Christmas. Jerks. Now, what do you want?
Mr. Ives, where did you get that ring?
What's it to you?
I'll buy it from you. How much do you want for it?
You can't even afford your power bill, let alone a diamond ring.
That's the utility bill. That payment's on time and it's all there. Now, how much do you want for the ring?
What is your interest, boy?
A girl that came to the theater lost her ring at a show a week ago. It was a gift from her mother. She got it when she was very young. It's very special to her. We searched all over for it, but we couldn't find it. But now, well, it's right there.
Oh, I see. Well, I tell you what, I'll make you a deal. I'll give you the ring if you give me the theater.
But that's her ring.
Actually, it's my ring. I paid good money for it. So, what do you say? Oh, come on. Lighten up, boy. It's Christmas. Yeah, it's Christmas.
Makes me feel like a little girl again. This is my favorite time of year. My mom, she always made it so special. Who are you spending Christmas with?
Family. And relatives and others, you know. You?
Yeah. Same.
Thanks for helping me all week. I enjoyed getting to know you very much.
You as well.
I know that you've probably got loads of people to see tonight, but you're more than welcome to stay for the show. A ticket free of charge, of course.
Merry Christmas. What do you want?
Mr. Ives, it's Graham at the Acorn Theatre.
Finally come to your senses, huh? Ready to sign that dump over to me?
Just have the damn papers ready, Ives.
Here's what we're gonna do. Okay, hello? Hello?
Hello? Hi. Yeah. Yeah, I'll be right there.